What's going on, guys? My name is Yankee and welcome back to another video today. Now in today's video I'm going to be answering your guys' questions regarding Call of Duty Infinite Warfare and COD 4 Remastered. Now as you guys know, about a week ago now I went to COD XP, I got my hands on both of these games, I got to play them a little bit, and I want to give my feedback to you guys and let you guys know what is good in the game and what is not good. So anyway guys, we're going to be getting right into this Q&A now, starting off with the first question. We didn't get too many questions, I was a little disappointed about that, but we're going to start off with Alpha Gaming, and he says, this game kind of looks gross. I'm hopeful for this game, but the maps look and feel like ghosts to me. Is this true or not? Now, the best way that I could really explain this, yes, the maps kind of do feel like Call of Duty Ghosts, but it's in the good way. Now, you guys remember all the maps in Call of Duty Ghosts, a lot of them, people did not like them because they were too big and the maps were just way too wide open. The game kind of played way too slow paced. The way that I could really basically explain this the best way is that it feels like the good maps in Call of Duty Ghosts, like Sovereign, like Fringe, those maps were the really good maps that I really did enjoy playing because it was a tight close quarters map and it felt good. So that's kind of like how it felt in Infinite Warfare. The best way I can really explain the maps, it's like a mixture of Call of Duty Ghosts and a mixture of maybe a little bit of Modern Warfare 3 as well. I think it plays very well. The game is not too slow paced like it was in Call of Duty Ghosts. I think Infinity Ward fixed the mistakes that they made from Call of Duty Ghosts, and I think the maps are gonna be very, very good. All the ones I played so far are a lot of fun. They're not too big and they're not too small. They play perfectly. So that's the best way I can really explain this one. Now coming into the next one, this question is coming from Aspire, and he says, will Infinite Warfare be a good pub stomping COD game? Now honestly, there's not really a really way to answer this question, because I feel like every single Call of Duty game is the same way when it comes to pub stomping. There's some things that you can do. You can go for nuclears, you can go for nukes, you can go for MOABs, DNA bombs, whatever the case may be. They're going to have those again. You can go for the high kill streaks. It's going to be the same way that it always is in any other Call of Duty game. The best way that I can really explain this, though, is that Infinite Warfare and COD 4 Remastered is going to be the best year in Call of Duty for content creation. Not really pub stomping, but content creation. Anyone that's a content creator on YouTube, you better be starting to get on your grind, really, because honestly, the possibilities are endless with the things that you can do. You can do GBs in Infinite Warfare and COD 4. You can go for really insane gameplays on both of these games. Like, it's going to be insane the amount of things that are going to be available for you. So I guess pub stomping, in a sense, will be pretty good in this year as well, because there's so many things. You can go for double nuclears. There also is going to be a nuke returning into the game as well. I'll talk about that in a video in the future, trying to explain a little more about what the nuke is going to be like in Infinite Warfare, because it's a lot different, but just know that there is going to be a nuke returning here in the game as well. So there's going to be so many different options that you can choose from things that you can go for good gameplays, good content creation. So I do think this will probably be the best year on YouTube for Call of Duty. There's just so many things that you can possibly do. You can go for competitive matches, you can go for really high scoring gameplays, you can just do a bunch of different things with two different games, which I think is going to be really cool. Now coming on to the next question now, this one's going to come in from Julian Aquando. I know for a fact I said that wrong. I really do apologize about that. But he says, is there any guns related to any of the Modern Warfare guns? Now, this is something that's actually going to be really interesting as well. No, there's not going to be really any guns that I really saw. There is one that looks like kind of like a Vector a little bit that I got to play around with a little bit. So that's the best one I can really explain that kind of looks related to a Modern Warfare gun. But there also is going to be like a classic gun play category as well, where you're going to be able to use like the Intervention from Modern Warfare 2. You're going to be able to use maybe like the ACR from Modern Warfare 3. Stuff like that is gonna be returning. I don't know if that's gonna be in the game at launch or if that's gonna be out of like supply drops and stuff like that, but anyway, there are gonna be guns that are very similar to the Modern Warfare guns as well. That's something to be really excited about. I'm really looking forward to playing with guns like the UMP45, the Intervention. Bringing those stuff into Infinite Warfare is gonna be a ton of fun. Now we only got two more questions left. This one comes from Delaney Peleas, and he says, do you think Infinite Warfare will be just as great or better than Black Ops 3? So we're gonna start with that, because he actually had two questions here. Do I think it's gonna be good? Honestly, I really did enjoy playing Black Ops 3. The movement system was not as crazy as it was in Advanced Warfare, so it was a lot slower down. It's basically the same way in Infinite Warfare as well. The movement system, maybe it would be a little slower as well, where there is still gonna be wall running. You can only wall run for a certain amount of time though, and the movement system, it just does not play as fast as it was in Infinite War and Black Ops 3, I should say. So it's gonna be a lot of fun. I really do like the movement system. And he also says, what do you think about the weapons and score streaks? And to be honest with this, the score streaks, I didn't get to use a lot of them, but some of them were good. Again, everything needs to be buffed and nerfed in this game. There was one weapon I'm not gonna say off the top of my head though. It was an assault rifle. That thing was just an absolute melt machine. I got so many kills with that, and then I switched to like a submachine gun, and I was just getting melted from people using that gun. So again, there's a lot of guns that are gonna need some buffing and nerfing to it, but honestly, I do think that they're gonna be a lot of fun. It does take a little bit to get used to, though. Some of them do have a little bit of recoil to them, so you still got to get used to that. And the score streaks, they could be a little better. I mean, the couple of ones that I used, though, were not the greatest ones. So again, they're not like the really high tier kill streaks. I never got to anything that was like that. But so far, I really did it like that. They were a lot of fun, and I think that this is going to be a really fun year for Call of Duty. So moving on to the final question. Again, this comes from Julian Aquendo. I don't even know. I'm really sorry. I'm definitely saying that wrong. But he says, do you prefer advanced movement or boots on the ground? And for me, this is basically the obvious answer. For me, I honestly prefer the boots on the ground because the advanced movement system, it's kind of getting repetitive already. We're in the third year of that. We've seen it in Advanced Warfare, Black Ops 3, and now here in Infinite Warfare. I do prefer going back to the boots on the ground, but that is the reason why we're getting COD 4 remastered as well. You get the best of both worlds. You get to have the boots on the ground, and then you also get to have the advanced movement system where you're run walling, you're jumping up in the air, which I think is very, very cool. Why I really am excited for Call of Duty this year, because if you don't like the advanced movement system, go play COD 4 for the whole entire year. There's still a lot of things that you can do in that game that haven't been done yet and before, so I'm very excited about that. But those are the only questions that I got, guys. I'm really disappointed. I wish I was going to get a little more. I wanted to talk a little more to you guys about Infinite Warfare, maybe even COD 4 as well. I didn't really get to talk about it that much, but if you guys did enjoy today's video, be sure to drop a like, guys, and if you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe, guys. We are on the road to 3,000 subscribers, so I really hope that we can hit that very soon. I'm really excited about that, guys. Anyway, thank you all so much for watching. Thanks to everyone who submitted their questions. If you guys want to see another Q&A about Infinite Warfare, I mean, if we get enough questions, you guys can leave some questions down below, maybe more towards Modern Warfare Remastered, because we didn't really talk about that much in this video. But if you do want to see another one, be sure to comment down below leaving your questions. I really would like to make another one of these videos. It would be really cool. Hopefully, you guys would be looking forward to that as well. Thank you all so much for watching. Have a good day, guys. Peace out. Come on.